Alright guys, just got home, hoping, yeah, you know what this is. I got some boxes for the Lexus. That's light. That's heavy. Okay, we'll see how these things work out. Let's unbox. So I'm all out of breath. This thing says heavy team lift. So I don't know. It is heavy, guys. So this should store 4 rotors and 4 sets of pads for the Lexus. I got the power stop ones. Let's just see what they look like inside real quick. I just got back from work. Long day. Alright, so I got... Oh, I didn't know I got power stop carbon fiber ceramic performance pads. Low dust formula for fast braking and hardware included. Oh, that's cool. All right. Carbon fiber ceramic pads. I had no idea I got carbon fiber ceramic pads. So I got the Z32 brake kit on Amazon. Uncle Fro got it for his Acura TL. And he's stoked on them. Right? So I figured might as well. So I got front and rear pads. Obviously these are the front because they're way heavier. I'm just going to throw that in the hatch. Hopefully Fro don't mind. I'm curious as I see these rotors though. Oh, I gotta get a knife. Alright, whatever. Didn't find a knife. Found a screwdriver. But the cool thing that I thought about these is that I know I'll get some heat from it. Drilled and slotted. I know people talk about rear passenger side. That's cool. Tells you which one so you don't mix up these grooves, I'm guessing. Alright guys. Well, I am not doing that right now. I just put about 10 miles of freeway driving on the Lexus, but we've got some brakes for the Lexus and we'll be working on that when I snap my fingers. But yeah, one thing I didn't tell you guys, 5 years later, after getting the filter so dirty without ever cleaning other than hitting it with some you can kind of see, put you in the light, that bluish tint to it compared to what it is now. I guess he's like the, I forget what they're called. I got the Web Nano Fiber Dry Filter. The only thing I was kind of bummed about here, and I'll pop it for you. And maybe you guys can enlighten me. Maybe I got the wrong filter. This is like the only 3-inch filter that I found from engine. And I'm trying to keep with engine only based on the fact that I've got the carb sticker for it in the glove box because it fell off. But I don't know if you guys remember this hose. Actually, still tapped in to right there. It actually helps on the freeway. If you can focus there. But obviously, right? Huge difference. Bam. But look at the size of the filter though. It's just wider. You know? So I don't know. Hope that doesn't hurt the performance. I was just mashing on it, and it feels really good. I don't know if it is because of the filter change, but I did catch another box. And hopefully it's something cool or not something lame. I forget, I've been ordering stuff. I don't even know what I got. Oh, that's for work. What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. We're here working on the Lexus. Froze on the other side of the car. He's trying to rush. He just got off of work, and we're going to do a brake job on the Lexus. So just real quick, you take off the 14s first. Off the back right here, off of this, and the caliper, there's like two little ones. You take those off, and then you can pop this off, and just make sure you rest it on something so it doesn't get this right here, because if this falls, it ends up putting a lot of pressure on this. It could easily crack it, and I just did it, so don't do what I did. Fro put his in a box, I put mine in a bungee. So now 17s in the back of this thing. All right, y'all, show right there. Not very well explained. There's plenty of other better videos. But that one right there, and the one right below it, it's already started backing out, all right? And then I'll be able to pop this bad boy off, and then we got a little 8mm bolt here, or 10, I don't know what it is. You screw that in to the rotor. On the little Honda Civics, we got the little Phillips head that you unscrew. This is just a bolt. I can't do it left-handed. We got a little bit of rust on here. But nevertheless, you put that in there, and that'll pop that brake rotor out. It's been in there for a long-ass time. You can see some pitting and some hot spots, and the caliper's just rusty as shit. I mean, the rotor's rusty as shit, so let's pull these guys out. That rotor's off. Got the new one on, holding it on with some lug nuts. Now I'm gonna try to tackle all of that bullshit.
Are we racing?
No. All right, backs need to get done. Car's flipped around. Pro did his side a lot faster than mine. His was messy. I hit it with some spray paint. But the rotors are cool.
They look good.
They're power stop evolution pads and power stop evolution rotors. They're slotted and drilled. So let's do this. All right, we're back. Next day, I got this shit done. Froke and I realized that after we took it all apart, it was falling apart in pieces. We got this spring back together, if you see that. That was a bitch, because this whole system was all in pieces. And then this one right here, for some reason, if you can see, is hitting right there. And we can't figure out why, so.
It's either a bent spring, bad retainer, or a replacement pin. So there's the rebuild.
So yeah, there's a rebuild kit. That's the part number 17393 for the Lexus. And while I was there, I went and I picked up these. I had to go to three different fucking auto zones for it. Fucking thing. Isn't that, see how hard that thing is to open? I was at AutoZone trying to open it in front of the old man. I couldn't open the fucking box, dude. And he's like, and I was like,
I just ripped it.
So, shoes. Brake drums. Believe that. We got brake drums for fucking e-brakes. So. Either way, I'm done with it. Fro's done with it. We're going to have Nacho come over here and fuck with this shit. And we'll record that. But that's where we are today. The fronts came together pretty well, and they look good. Real good. All right, we'll see you guys when Nacho comes back. All right, guys, welcome back. It's been 4 days? 4 days? So, 4 days since I left off. Long and the short, I got a hard work hit. Okay, So in this hardware kit, here's one of these. Okay. This was the bad one. That's the good one. Just that little bit caused the back of that spring, which looks like this, to be poking and hitting the back of the hub, but I got it all swapped out. Put in the new pads, the new rotors. I'm gonna put the shit back together. And I'm not taking it all apart because that was the only sharp part that was bent. I'm gonna put it back together. Turns out I had dealership pads. So Lexus rotors and pads, they were just time to go. So the pads weren't bad. The rotors weren't bad. They're just, I guess, some hard on them. I don't know what it was. Maybe I could have shaved them, but slight warpage on them. Either way, upgrade, right? All right, let's do it. All right, so now that I got the car jacked up, I wanted to show you guys a couple things on the car. I've talked to you guys in the past about it, but these wheels aren't wide enough, so I've got some spacers. But the UPRD axle back, custom exhaust, made by Under Pressure Racing Development. And then the mid pipe right there is a Top Speed, which has that piece right there with the two, and then those two pieces as well, and then the axle back, which connects, right? And then I've got the Megan down pipe, Y pipe. And that had to get extended, just so you guys know, that much. That goes to the stock cats. You guys can see I've got that crossbar, and that goes over the top of the stock one, so it does take some abuse because my car is kind of low. And then I got the rear cross brace as well, with the Megan coilovers and Megan front and rear sway bars, if you can see, but you can't, which I'll show you. You sit towards the front of the car. Focus. See? And right there. As well as I have the chain rear strut tie bar upper. I also have these bars, which you can see right there on both sides. And then taking some abuse. And I have this one, which you can see it right here. And that's a rear lower strut tie bar that goes underneath, but my exhaust hangs in the way, as well as a front upper strut tie bar. So just some specs on the suspension I got, guys. And these are just the Megan Easy coilovers. So all right, I guess it was a success. It's definitely, it's good for a spin around the block, like real quick. I mean, I didn't even take it over 20 miles an hour. But everything's rolling and turning and making no crazy noises. There is a hiss, like a sss, but it's because these pads and these rotors are very abrasive. They're cross, like sanded, or I don't know what the fuck you call it, but either way, it works. I haven't broken them in yet. I know there's a video on it. You're supposed to, while they're cold, like, I guess you're supposed to get it to like 60, hit the brakes almost to a 5 mile an hour roll. Don't lock them up completely, but lay on them pretty heavily and do it like 3 times, get it to where they're really hot, and then let them cool off as long as you can go, you know, preferably like 20, 30 minutes of just cool driving. And supposedly that does something to these pads, so, and prevent them from the, because that's what it just did when I was backing it up in here right now. But one thing I did get Which I also got to do, which I'm not too stoked on, because Nacho came by the other day and was like, oh man, that's a pain in the ass. That's in the subframe, and if you fuck up that, good luck. So this is what I got. Got it from Amazon. I did some searching, and I found these. So this is the lower front. I know that this bushing, it feels like it's going on mine. So I got this. Both front and left, or driver's side and passenger side, and some upper control arms. Now I got these because of these bushings here and the new upper ball joint. So I get what you guys are thinking. Honestly guys, I'm not a stance guy. I don't really want to adjust my camber in the front unless it's to get a better track patch on the actual ground, you know what I mean? But I'm really not trying to camber out or have to get a set of wheels that I need a camber for. So yeah, I need to get a set of wheels, so I don't want to deal with the big brake, which is why I didn't get the LS rotor and caliper. But hey, it is what it is. Car's driving. I'll get these arms on, and I'll get these upper control arms on in one of the next couple videos. The Civic, big surprise. We, in the midst of wiring it, something's missing in here, and that's our switch panel box, if that gives you a clue. So we got all ride wire up to here. Now we're getting a switch box to run our wires for the back and the front, but we'll show you guys all that. Once that's done, guys, we're ready to just plumb the coolant system in and start it. So hopefully that happens ridiculously fast, guys. Fro's been trying to get this done. I've been trying to get it done. The Accord needs some attention. I've got parts just sitting on shelves for the Accord, a throttle body, a set of cams, a fuel rail, fuel pressure riser, engage. We even got an extra fuel pump, but I already got a wobberoo on that thing. So all I need for that thing really right now to buy is going to be a set of injectors and a Honda S300. So if you guys got a hookup on that, help me out, because I need one right now. But either way, guys, thanks for hanging out. Sorry these videos are inconsistent, and summer's coming. We're going to have some more time, and I'm going to have a little bit more money to start throwing at some parts. So I'm starting to accumulate them. As you can see, little by little, I'll get the Lexus just tuned in. And yeah, they don't look too bad, guys. You know, I did hit the calipers with a little touch of some caliper paint. I just used I've got a multiple different kinds of, I've used VHT. I like VHT. Duplicolor works, just super lightweight, and you gotta lay it the right way. It's super sensitive, but if you do it right, it actually lays well. It doesn't chip but it doesn't lay thick. So it's just such a funky smell to it too. It's kind of, but sorry, got off on a tangent. Either way, thanks for hanging out, guys. I'll talk to you soon, within the next couple of days, hopefully. And peace out. Thanks for watching. Peace.